Hi, this is Tawny with the Kinsmen Republic Library, and I thought I would go over some fun resume tips since I've had some people come into the library asking for resume help. I thought I would share mine and what is really good about it and what is bad about it, and how to make it easier for hiring managers to find. So this is my resume. You'll notice at the top it has my name and a few things that are blanked out because one's my email, my phone number, and then my personal LinkedIn and also portfolio. So I have those all blanked out just for privacy and protection purposes. They are really good ideas because one, you want the hiring managers to be able to contact you. A portfolio lets them learn a little bit more about what you're putting further down in the resume, as does the LinkedIn. So you'll notice that I have experience listed first, as well as an objective. Actually, you don't actually need objectives anymore. So I could just get rid of that. Also, it's very vague and very dull. So when you're job hunting, you actually want to tailor your resumes to specific positions and places. So you don't want to just be very vague and general about it because that kind of doesn't make them want to take you seriously. So you'll notice that I go by my most current job and then my next current. I also am only showing my library work. Because this is a resume that I could theoretically use for job hunting in the library industry. So I have my most previous one, the one I'm currently at. I have my job duties, as well as something about social media growth. So these numbers are a little bit out of date. I have some updating to do, which brings me to another point. You should be updating this at least a couple times a year, anytime you get a new title or you get a new job. When you graduate from school or you do any kind of professional development, it's really good to update your resume and put it on there, especially if you just have like one master resume where you can keep everything. And then as you need to job hunt or apply to different jobs or you want to apply to a different job, you can just pull out those bits that are useful to what you're applying to and not have to completely make new resumes from scratch every single time. So one of the reasons why I have the social media follower accounts on my resume is because they like these concrete numbers. Like this shows a very easily verifiable proof of growth and knowledge and experience in these different social media outlets. They can go and look and they can be like, oh yes, they really do have these much followers, and they can go through past posts and see how I've improved and grown and been able to learn how to adequately use social media. You'll notice that I also have marketing flyers for all of my programs listed as a skill and job duty, which is where my portfolio would come in hand. They can go online to that website and look at past advertising as well as the advertising I have posted to all social media accounts. You'll also notice that underneath I have my job that I had right before this, same library, but you'll notice that I've changed titles and job duties. So I had to add a whole new job entry. I was library aide. That's a bit more general because it wasn't like I didn't have anything going on with this job. It was just I was very much support, and these were my legit duties. I didn't really start taking risks until I became a technology educator, so that's why that might not look as exciting. I also have my education listed. You'll notice I only have my two degrees. I don't list college, high school. If you have a bachelor's or a master's, it's kind of assumed that you've graduated from high school or that you have your GED, so you don't have to list that as well. I only listed both degrees because they kind of play into each other and they will help show that I have not only skill in library with a focus on kids and youth librarianship, but also that I have a little bit of a research background as well. So that can help me make me look much more appealing. And then this old one had skills at the bottom. So this is just very general. I kind of reiterated what was up here. So you really don't want to do that. It's also recommended that if you do have a skills section, that you would put this to the top because the top third of your resume is what's going to be seen immediately by hiring managers. So that's the most important part. You want to be able to take a quick glance and go, oh, Okay, perfect. This is who we want to call in so that they have all your contact info and what makes you worth their time is already up there. Also, if I were editing this for job hunting purposes, I would want to pull specific words out of the job listing so that I am easily found by any kind of software they might use, or my resume will pop just that much more. So you'll see words like reader's advisory, which is a very library-centric term. It just kind of means I can recommend books to people. I know how to do that and how to find books for people who might not be into it or might need help not know what they're looking for. So that's all that kind of means. But using that kind of jargon that might pop up in a job listing is going to help your resume get seen so much more. Also, length. You kind of want to keep it between 1 to 2 pages. That's why I mentioned having a master resume with all of your past and current jobs listed on it so that you can just pull what you want. You don't want to give them 3, 4, 5 pages of a resume because that's a lot of information to read through and they're not going to want to take that time because that's just too much to go through. So if you just pull out the important bits that they need to know about you and all the jobs that directly apply to them or that you can maybe word things in such a way that makes them apply, that's what you want to do. Also, don't worry if you only have 1 or 2 jobs in that specific field showing up on your resume because it's going to ask how long you've been there. So obviously, length is going to be super helpful. It's going to show that you've been there for a while, you're committed, you do have all this experience there, and that you weren't just job hunting, which isn't anything bad, but it can still negatively impact you depending on your employer or future employer's school of thought. So some people are really okay with job jumping, and others are a little bit leery of people who do that. So you kind of just want to maybe make sure you have long and short ones if that is what your resume looks like, just to kind of help back you up and make sure that they take you as seriously as you completely and utterly deserve. So this is my resume. There's a lot I have to change. I hope it helps. I hope you feel confident to write your own and you kind of have an idea of what to do. These tips are kind of just all over the internet and it sounds kind of like, well, duh. But when you're trying to write your own resume, it's really tricky and kind of hard to know where to get started. So don't be afraid to use a template to get a good idea of how to organize. Maybe you just legit have never written one, so you don't even know how to organize the info or get where to start. Go ahead and just do that. Maybe just, switch it up a little bit, make it yours, and make sure that your font is always at least like an 11 to 12. You don't want it too small or too big, and that it's a very easy to read typeface. So I hope that helps. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time.